as we at Fox Sports honor Juneteenth, the celebration of freedom, which began in Galveston, Texas, about an hour south of where we're at in Houston at Minute Maid Park, as we get set for Game 3 of a fantastic four-game series between the Chicago White Sox and the Houston Astros. Let's dial in on the home team. It has been a wild and eventful week for the Astros, starting on Tuesday after Carlos Correa saved the Astros with a homer in the ninth, a 10th inning walk-off grand slam for Jose Altuve to beat the Texas Rangers. They would go on to win both games in that series, and they've taken the first two against the White Sox after another walk-off last night when Yordan Alvarez got the first walk-off hit of his career to score Yuli Gurriel in a game that was 1-1 all the way to the bottom of the ninth. The Astros have now made it five consecutive wins with that victory in walk-off fashion last night. They're trying to make it six straight series wins. Had it not been for the Red Hot Athletics, the Astros might be in first place. That's where the White Sox are in the American League Central. Adam Amin, AJ Pierzynski, glad you're with us tonight, and glad we get to watch this red-hot Houston offense. They've been dynamite as of late and fantastic all year.
They are the best offense in baseball going 1-9, even without Alex Bregman in the lineup, who's out right now. But they are first in pretty much every statistical category that matters. You see some of them there, runs per game, average, slugging, OPS. We ran out of graphics. Our poor graphics department didn't have enough room. But the thing that they do have, the first guy in their lineup, Jose Altuve, especially this month of June, he has been on fire. He is hitting for average, he's hitting for power, and that's the key. The former MVP, the former batting champion, the former multi-time All-Star has found his power stroke in June, and he's got an outside shot at the all-time Astros record for home runs in a month, because we're not quite all the 3 weeks into June yet.
He's never had a 10 home run month in his career, has a chance for it down the stretch. Let's talk about another first, the guy who's first in the American League in ERA. That's Lance Lynn. He's trying to play stopper tonight.
Well, after a two-game losing streak in this series for the White Sox, they turned to the guy who's been their most consistent and best pitcher for the entire year so far. Lance Lynn leads the league in ERA, and he's in the top five in a lot of other statistical categories. This guy attacks with the fastball. He has three different fastballs. He will not deviate from that plan, Adam. He will attack these Astros hitters with fastballs, and the Astros hitters, they hit fastballs. So this is going to be a fun matchup to see which one wins, but I cannot wait to see this battle.
And on the other side of things, Framber Valdez, who was so key to the Astros' postseason run last year, is back from a finger injury. He makes his fifth start of the year tonight. He has been fantastic so far. A lot of the White Sox will get their first looks at Valdez tonight. As we get set for Baseball Night in America, all of you 30-somethings, get excited. It's Tom DeLong.
Ready to get radical. Catch big air. Strut your stuff. Well, you've come to the right place. It's baseball night in America.